Now we have individually seen the application of addition theorem and multiplication theorem. Now in this video we will see how the both theorems can be applied simultaneously in one question. So I'll show you with one example, like how you can apply multiplication as well as addition theorem in one practical sum. Now see, in this practical question we have been given the information that there is a bag which contains 10 white balls and 6 black balls. Now 4 successive draws of one ball each. It means one by one we are drawing the balls. That is ball number 1, 2, 3 and 4. So 4 successive draws. Successive means one after another we are drawing one ball each. So one by one we are drawing and balls are not replaced. And the ball that has been taken out from the bag is not being replaced, is not being put up again. So what is the chance that they are alternatively of different colors? So we have to find out that 4 draws that have been made, they are alternatively of different colors. It means white, black, or it can be black, white. So we have 2 options, black and white. So now in the question, it will not be written that you have to apply multiplication and addition theorem simultaneously. From the language, we have to identify this. So as we can see, there are 10 balls and 6 black balls. So what will be the first ball? We have no surety according to the question. Nothing is being written about the first ball. So we will assume that if, or we can say we will take it as case number 1. So we can just have 2 cases. So case number 1 will be, if the first drawn ball is white. So we are starting with white. So this will become our first case. So if first drawn ball is white, so it means we will start with probability that, yeah, probability of getting white ball. That is the first ball. So we will consider it to be PA. So how many white balls are there? 10 favorable cases upon total number of cases in the question are 10 plus 6, that is 60. So if the first ball is white ball, of course the second ball will be black, because in the question it was written they are alternatively of different colors. So now we will find out probability of getting a black ball. Second ball will be black ball. So probability of getting a black ball will be considered as PB. So PB, now black balls were 6. But total balls will not be 16 because one white ball has already been taken out. So favorable cases, black balls are there in the bag, so 6, but total number of cases have been converted into 15. Now what will be the third ball? Third ball will again be white because we have shown it to be alternatively of different colors. So probability of getting white ball, it will become PC. So how many white balls are there? There are 9 white balls left in the bag. And what about total balls? There are 14 because 2 balls have already been withdrawn. So what will be the fourth ball? Fourth ball will again be black. So probability of drawing a black ball, that is PD. So how many balls are there black? It will be 5 because one has already been withdrawn and total balls are 30. So this is our case number 1. When we are just considering that the first ball, drawn ball is white. Now we have to move on to case number 2. So what will be the case number 2? Case number 2 or option number 2 can be, if the first drawn ball is black. If the first drawn ball is black, it means we will start with probability of drawing the black ball because first ball is black. So we will consider it to be PA. So how many black balls were there? We have seen in the question there were 6 black balls. So out of 16, 10 plus 6, so first ball will be black. So if the first ball is black, second ball we have seen to be white because alternatively they should be of different colors. So PB, total white balls in the bag were 10, but total balls will not be 16, that is already being reduced by 1 ball. The third ball will again be a black ball, that is PC. So now 5 balls are left in the bag. Earlier it was 6, now 5 upon 14. In the same way, the fourth ball drawn will be again white, that is PD. So it will be 9 because 10 were earlier, so 9 upon 13. So like this we will prepare two cases. I repeat again, case number 1 we have considered as the first drawn ball is white and the second drawn ball is black. And the case is reverse in case of case 2. Now which of these cases will be occurring in our question? Either this can happen or this can happen. So we have to consider this the case of either or. Right? Again. Now these are the four draws. In individual case, four draws have been made. First ball has been taken and then second ball has been taken and then third ball has been taken and then fourth ball has been taken. It means internally in every case multiplication theorem will be applied. But in these two cases only one case can happen. So either this is going to happen or this is going to happen. So now how we will represent it? Now you will be writing the line of the question. So how we will write the line of the question? The line what was asked in the question is the chance that the balls will be alternatively of different colors. So we can say probability of drawing balls of different colors either the first case can happen. So what was the first case? The first case was first ball 10 upon 6 and second ball and then third ball was drawn and then fourth ball was drawn. So in case of and we know that we put multiplication theorem. So here we have applied multiplication theorem. Or means plus. We have seen in case of either or we apply the plus sign. Or the second case can happen. So what was our second case? Second case was 6 upon 16 into 10 upon 15 into 5 upon 14 into 9 upon 13. So these were the values from our case 2. So this finally we have put the question in the format as it was required. So internally in every case multiplication theorem is being applied and among two cases as one case can happen. So we have applied the addition theorem. So now we will solve these values and finally we will reach the conclusion. Let's solve this. This will be deleted. So it will be 45/728 plus this also you will solve. So it will be same 45/728. So taking the LCM it will be 90/728. So again we can divide or keep in fractions as much as possible. So it will be 45/364. So this is how you can apply in one question multiplication as well as addition theorem simultaneously.